Everyone, today in this session we are going to learn about maths function. Math function. What is maths function? So first of all, I'm just going to explain you guys. So basically, we have already done this thing. Like we have so many packages in our Java inside packages. We have our classes inside classes. We have so many function. We are one of the class like a math class is very important class. Like regarding maths, the simple calculations. Like if you want to find out a square or a cube root or a square root or power of any number, or if you want to round up, or if you want to find out, any random number, or if you want to do any simple maths calculations, so that can be done. The code is already written inside the class, guys. We have few functions we just can use. Simply, we know that we have a next int is a function of class scanner. Again, similarly, we have a math is again a class, just like a scanner class, where we have few, cooked and ready-made functions which we can use in our day-to-day life. And in our simple calculation also can be used. So here I'm just going to implement in my Java project work. I'm creating here a new class and I'm simply writing here calculation. So I'm just writing here cal and one. So here I'm having a class, I'm coming inside and I'm going to explain you the simple, very simple calculation. Like if you want to find out a power or of any 10, 1030 value or 1060 value. So we have so many functions available here in math class, which we can use. So simply I'm just going to start here a class and I'm writing here the name of my class, that is C is capital of Cal 1. I'm coming back to my class. I'm creating a space. I'm coming up here. I'm writing here public static void main. Public static void main. And I'm just coming up inside. This is a very short session today, guys, because we have only ready-made function use, and math class is just a class where you will be getting so many ready-made function. You just need to know how to use those ready-made functions. So if in any question or anywhere in a competitive exam, if you are being asked, like you just need to print a series where you need to calculate some powers, you need to print and it contains only 1 mark or 2 marks. So then these functions are very reliable and very simple. You don't need to write a very long logic. You just can use this simple ready-made cooked functions and your work will be done. So I'm just going to explain you the very first function is SQRT, with the help of which you will be able to find out square root. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to write your system.out.println and you will be able to know with the help of this, like whatever input you're going to give, you will get to know the output very easily, like direct on console you can see. One more thing I want to say, guys, that this math class is a static class. I'm going to teach you a static classes soon. I just want to give you a very simple and a very short description of a static classes. These classes are not dependent on object. Basically, we don't need to create any object for such classes. These classes can be accessed with its name directly. You just write the name of this classes and you write dot and you direct write the name of the function and you will be able to access that function. Simply, you can see like a scanner is again a class. We create the object of a scanner class and with the help of object, we access next int and next float and all these ready-made functions. But with the help of a math class, you don't need to create any object. This is a static class. Direct, you can write its name. You can put dot. You can access any function. Similarly, like system, if you have seen system is again a class, you simply write system dot println and you use it. You never create object of system class. So few classes we have in a Java where we don't need to create any object. Direct, we can write the name of such classes. We put dot, we access the functions. Even we can also create such kind of classes. These classes are known as static classes. Soon we are going to learn this static classes and its uses, like how to use it basically. So soon we will be able to know the main use of static classes in our next session. So right now I'm just going to continue with my math class only. How to access math class? First of all, I just write here system.out.println. I write here math dot, I write here. And then direct the name of the function I'm going to write here. So the name of the function is SQRT. So I'm just writing here SQRT. In bracket, I'm going to write here like whatever square root if I need to find out the square root of 4. So it is going to return me the square root of 4. Along with this, I would also like to mention here a comment so that you will be able to understand like what my math.sqrt function is doing here. So I'm simply writing here math.sqrt because I'm using a math.sqrt and I'm putting here concatenation operator and here my work will be done. I'm copying, I'm coming to my next line, I'm pasting. And then I'm writing here CBRT. CBRT is cube root. So CBRT, I'm simply writing here CBRT. And CBRT, the name of the function also I'll be writing here. So this is CB, RT, you can see. So cube root, I'll be able to know. So I can write here any number, like I'm writing here 8, and I'll be able to know the cube root of 8. Second, the function which I'm using, that is power function. So math.power, it means you will able to know, you will get to know like what is the use of power, means how, what my power function can do here. So I'm simply going to write here math.power, power. And basically it is not full spelling, we just need to write here POW. So it is going to tell me the power, like but the base and the power, both the numbers I just need to write here. So I'm writing here base, and second I'm writing here power. So that is 2^2, and I'll get to know what is the power. So we have these many functions which we can use. Also, I'm going to add here a few more functions, like if you are finding a square root, but if you want to do some other calculation with this, this is again possible. You can write here math.square root, and along with this, if you want to add 2 with this, so this is the simple sub calculation. If you want, you can add with this, and this is again can be done. Now, one more thing I'm going to tell you here, we have a few, you know, round functions also available here. This I'm going to explain you here. Next function, what I'm going to use here, ABS, that is absolute value. Like if any number, any negative value, if you are giving, so it will be converted into positive, and positive will be negative. So I'm simply going to write here ABS. This is ABS function. I'm simply writing here ABS, and inside bracket, I'm writing here -4. One more thing I would like to add up here is they are going to return this value. All these functions like math.sqrt, math.cbrt, math.pow, math.abs, they are going to return you. Sometimes they are going to return you integer, but mostly they return you the double value, in the value in form of double. But if you want, you can convert it definitely. If you want, you can convert it. We have already done conversion. So if you want, you can convert it. You can write here a float, so the value will be converted here in form of float. If you want to write here double or integer, the value can be converted. So you know how to convert, so you can use the same thing. Next thing, what I'm going to use here is, I'm going to use here seal function. What the seal function is going to do here, it is just going to cover your value. Like this function rounds a floating point value up to the nearest integer value. Like you can see math.seal 7.343. If you are writing, you will be getting answer 8.0. So I'm simply going to use here the seal function, C-E-I-L, seal I'm writing here. And I'm just going to give here some value, and the value would be 7.343. So I'm just going to write this value. I'm coming to my next line. Next, I'm going to teach you here that floor. Floor is again a combination of seal, but you know, a little difference is there in all these things. In floor, what is going to happen is, in floor, this function rounds a floating point value down to the nearest integer value. So this you need to keep it in your mind, that seal, you know, point value up to the nearest integer value. And in case of float, it, you know, it is going to round a floating value down to the nearest integer value. This you need to understand. So I'm just using here, I'm writing here floor, and the same value I'm going to write here, what I have written inside seal, that is 7.343, and you will get to know the answer. So, you know, these like this, we have so many functions. The second function which I'm going to use here, let me change the caption so that you will be able to understand the impact. Here I'm writing floor, and this is my seal, C-E-I-L-C. I'm just coming up here. Next, what I'm going to explain you is min. So I'm just writing here MI, and min means minimum value. Whatever minimum value is, without any code, you can find it out. Only you just need to write here small MI and min. This is min. And I'm just writing here 2 values. I just need to put here comma, and I can write 2 values. But you need to understand this thing. You can write only 2 values. From 2 values, it will let you know whether the min, what is the minimum value. Same, what you can do is you can find out the maximum value also. I'm simply going to paste here, and I'm writing here max. So whatever the max value, whatever the maximum value is here, you will get to know. But again, you just can write here only 2 values, and you will get to know 2 values. Now, next, what I'm going to use here, math.round, a simple function that is round. It is just going to round whatever value I'm giving here. It is just going to round. So I'm just going to write here in caption, first of all, that is round, and then I'm going to use here the function. All right. So I'm using here, I have already used here round. What I need to do is I have just given here a space which I need to remove from here. This is mat and dot. So this is my round function. I'm coming to my next line. Now the next function which I'm just going to use here, that is random. Random is again a wonderful, you know, function which is going to give you any random value, any random value. So most of the time we want random value. For example, I've designed a program through which the background, you know, automatically will change. Though in, this is a console programming, but again, applet is a kind of class through which I can design, you know, I can design the web browser based application also. But again, a part of this, for example, if I'm just checking my program, I'm just giving some random value to the computer and I'm checking my code. So you have a random function also available here. Random function is going to give you some random value automatically. So you just need to use it. It is so simple. I'm writing here random in a caption, and now I'm going to use here a random function here. So I just need to write here RANDOM. You can see it is so simple. I'm just applying indentation so that you will be able to see my whole screen. All right, I've applied indentation. Now you can see this is random. So what I can do is here I'm writing round because I just can give only two value, not two value, only one value can be given inside round. And in random, what we need to do is random, we just need to multiply this random function with the number like the range I want. For example, I just want any random value till 100. Till 100, I'm going to get a random value. So to get a random value between 0, for example, 100, multiply the value returned by math.random with the maximum number, for example, 100. So here, if I'm writing multiple 100, so I'm just going to get any random value. Even I can write this function, this simple function, I can write in loop also. So my loop is going to work 10 times and I'm going to get any random value 10 times till 100. So you can use this random function for this purpose. Next, I'm having exp function also. Exp means exponential also, you will get to know. So math.exp only you need to write here. I'm writing here exp caption. I'll be adding up later. So exponential exp I'm writing here, and I'm going to give only one value inside and I will get to know the result. Now I'm coming to my next line. Even I can find out here a log value also, like a math.log10 if you want to find out the value of log 10. So that also can be done. So this is, you know, if you are designing such applications where you are dealing with trigonometry applications or trigonometrical numericals you need to solve, if you need to find out log value or any mathematical software, if you are designing, if you are doing some calculations regarding mathematics, or if you want 10 theta value or sine theta, so these values don't need to see from anywhere. You know, math classes managing is maintaining all these things. Ready-made functions are already there. You just need to use it. Simple. You just need to use it and you will get to know. Okay. So same thing like math.sine value also we have here. Math.cos value also we have here. So any value you can give and you will get to know what is the math.sine value of this, what is the math.cos value of this, what is the math.tan value of this. So you will get to know any value. So this is that easy. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to click on compile. I'm going to run it and I'm going to show you the output screen. First of all, I'm just coming back and I'm just going to edit here few captions because I have not added. So I'm simply coming up here and I'm writing here log log. And here I'm just writing here exp. This is exp I have written here. Rest everything is done. I'm clicking on compile. My code is done. I'm coming back to my dashboard and Calvin, I'm going to run it and you will get to know the output of all the functions, whatever I have used here. You can see from here, this is my math CBRT, then power, then ABS, seal, floor, min, max, round, random, exp and log. So you are getting here a random value. I have told you if random function, if you're writing in any loop and if you're running your loop 10 times or 10 plus or 100 times, and each and every time you're going to get some random value because the random function is that usable. Most of the time we just check our code, we just check our program, we give some random value and we check it. So this is again possible. So thank you so much for attending today's session. Once you practice, you will be able to understand because these are the functions which you need to learn. So please practice and we will be meeting in our next session. Thank you.